Hey guys, Brady with Golf Ascending here, and today we're gonna give you a review of the Wishbone Push Cart. And if you haven't yet, make sure to subscribe to our channel. We do create weekly golf content, but let's get into this review. Tyson's gonna show us all about this push cart right now.
Hey guys, Tyson with Golf Ascending. Today, going to talk about the Wishbone Push Cart. Right up front, I'm gonna let you guys know it is $250, so, you know, as I'm getting into the specs here, just keep that in mind. So this push cart, one of the big things about it is it's very light and it does compact pretty good. We'll show some B-roll of that. But just, you know, as any other push cart, there's a lot of similar features there. We do have a locking system here. So it does lock into place. Just one wheel lock does the job really well. To unlock it, just pull that peg right out. When you're installing it, make sure that you're putting the gear wheel on the locking side, or else you're gonna have to pop it back out. Just some standard stuff about the push cart. We've got, you know, a place for a drink. We actually tested this at another golf course. I put a 44-ounce Coke in there and it fit great. Had no issue just, you know, squeezing it in there. We do have an umbrella holder here. You can unscrew it here, lift it up, tighten it, stick the umbrella in. We got a little tightener on the back here to secure the umbrella. We do have a spot here for a golf ball, so you can stick the golf ball there, as well as we have some slots for tees. As I said, it does, you know, fold up pretty nicely. It comes with a bag, the wheels come off, so, you know, it does fit in the trunk pretty good, and it's actually pretty easy to assemble. The wheels really do just kind of snap into place and you're good to go. The front wheel, I will say, it's got these two rods that go in, and it does take a little more effort to put in there. You kind of have to, like, you know, slam it in a little bit, but, you know, it makes sense because a lot of the weight is at the toe of the cart. But overall, you know, me and Brady have been, you know, testing these out for a while. As you guys can see, we've got the cart bag on here. So this is a big bag. Most people don't use a cart bag on a push cart. We figured for the review, it'd be good to give you guys the biggest and most, I guess the most elaborate example. You guys can definitely put your hybrid bags on here, your stand bags, carry bags, it'll fit a lot easier. I do want to talk about the securing mechanism here. So it is rubber, does stretch a little bit on this cart bag. Like I said, it does use the entire length of the secure system. So you don't really have to stretch it too much. It does fit. Same with the bottom. It uses that last little peg. But overall, you know, I'm pretty happy with it. I know push carts, you know, they can be a little bit expensive. $250, it might be on a little bit of a higher end, but you're probably gonna spend at least $125 on a push cart, you know, up to, you know, around 200. So if you want something that's light, that's reliable, you know, me and Brady have used this for a good amount, and we can say, you know, it is reliable. It does work really well, and we do like some of the features. Another cool thing, this does come in different colors. So mine has red accents with the black. There is a blue one, which Brady has, and then there is one, I believe it has lime green. We'll show pictures up here. But that's essentially, you know, a push cart and a review for you guys. You know, like I said, it is reliable. We've used it quite a bit, and we enjoy, you know, we enjoy walking every once in a while. And I think, you know, if you guys do go golfing a lot, sometimes it is refreshing to walk the course, and it's nice to have something that holds your clubs that, you know, you don't really have to worry about. Last thing I want to talk about in this review, so if you guys aren't aware, in push carts, when you arrange your clubs, make sure that you flop them, or I guess flip-flop them, especially with cart bags. Usually in a cart bag, your bigger clubs like driver are actually in the back, so when you put it on a push cart, you have to reverse everything and take a look at how nice this looks. You know, really easy to pull out. Hey, I need my 6-iron. Okay, you know, let's go. So anyways, that is the review of the Wishbone Push Cart.
All right guys, there you have it. There's the review. Tyson gave it, kind of speaking on the behalf of both of us. I also think this is a pretty darn good push cart. It's good quality. What I like about it, honestly, is that it is so smooth. The wheels, like, I wish my baby stroller was this smooth. I love it. But yeah, that's the review. If you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe. We do create weekly golf content, and we will see you next time.